فؤادك الأيام فت.
وقد وقع إجماع الأمة على أن من أنكر البعث كفر وقتل.
So the Sheikh رحمه الله تعالى, he's saying that a unanimous consensus has come in place. The Ummah have unanimously agreed upon that anybody who rejects the resurrection, he's a disbeliever and he is fought with, he's killed. So the Ijma' in this Ummah is one of the Mazdar al-Talaqi, it's one of the sources we take our evidences from. Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala says in the Quran, وَمَنْ يُشَاقِقِ الرَّسُولَ مِنْ بَعْدِ مَا تَبَيَّنَ لَهُ الْهُدَى وَيَتَّبِعْ غَيْرَ السَّبِيلِ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ وَلِّهِ مَا تَوَلَّى وَنُسْلِهِ جَهَنَّمْ وَسَاءَتْ مَصِيرًا. So that ayah is the evidence for what? Ijma'. The ayah clearly says, وَمَنْ يُشَاقِقِ الرَّسُولَ, anyone who diverts from the Prophet's path. So pay attention. Allah says, وَمَنْ يُشَاقِقِ الرَّسُولَ, the Prophet, مِنْ بَعْدِ مَا تَبَيَّنَ لَهُ الْهُدَى, after the evidence becomes clear to you, you go against what? You go against the Messenger Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam's path. Then Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala didn't just specifically mention the Prophet alone. He added something else to it. And goes against which path as well? غَيْرَ سَبِيلِ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ, the path of the believers as a whole. And mu'mineen means all the mu'mineen. نُوَلِّهِ مَا تَوَلَّى. Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala will allow you to go with whatever you went with. Whatever path you've taken, be with it inshaAllah. But what will happen in the day of judgment? نُوَلِّهِ مَا تَوَلَّى وَنُسْلِهِ جَهَنَّمَ. جهنم will be made his abode. وَسَاءَتْ مَصِيرًا. One of the ayats that show ijma' is the evidence, which is what? Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala, he says, فَإِنْ تَنَازَعْتُمْ فِي شَيْءٍ فَرُدُّوهُ إِلَى اللَّهِ وَالرَّسُولِ. If you guys dispute one another in a matter, bring it back to who? Allah and his messenger. So this ayah shows that bringing it back to Allah's messenger is when? When there is a dispute that lies. What about there is, when there is no dispute? So there are times when there's no disputes. And those times when there is no disputes is a mahalu ijma'. The Ummah unanimously agreeing on this issue. So that ayah also shows ijma' is a, which is a evidence that we do need to do it. But we have to follow the ijma'. There are ayat more. ولذلك this ayah, وَمَنْ يُشَاقِقِ الرَّسُولَ مِنْ بَعْدِ مَا تَبَيَّنَ لَهُ الْهُدَى وَيَتَّبِعْ غَيْرَ سَبِيلِ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ نُوَلِّهِ مَا تَوَلَّى وَنُسْلِهِ جَهَنَّمَ وَسَاءَتْ مَصِيرًا. Was an ayah that Imam al-Shafi'i tired him. A man came up to Imam al-Shafi'i rahimahullah ta'ala and he argued with him. And he said to Imam Shafi'i, where is the evidence for ijma'? Where is the evidence for consent? That we accept the consent of the Muslims, that we consent of the ulama. Where's your evidence on that? Imam Shafi'i said, give me days, I'll come back to you. Shafi'i read the Quran so many times, multiple times. And he couldn't find it. He got confused. The man came to him, he said, come back to me another time. He went back again, Imam Shafi'i read it from back to front again. And he came on this ayah and he stopped there. And he realized it's in this ayah. Another ayah that shows ijma' is evidence, which is what? Allah says, وَكَذَلِكَ جَعَلْنَاكُمْ أُمَّةً وَسَطًا. مَا مَعَنَا وَسَطًا? Allah explains it later for us. وَكَذَلِكَ جَعَلْنَاكُمْ أُمَّةً وَسَطًا لِتَكُونُوا شُهَدَاءَ عَلَى النَّاسِ. Witnesses over other people. Our testimony as this ummah Muhammadiyya as a whole is taken into consideration in the Day of Judgment. So why not in this dunya? Nuh alayhi salam will say, oh Allah, I conveyed my message. And it will be said to Nabiullah Nuh, who's your evidence that you conveyed your proof to the Ummah? Your Ummah. Where's your evidence that you conveyed the message? And he will say, Ummah to Muhammad. Well, Muhammad wasn't there. They have the text for it. So he will use us as a what? As a reference point. So the ijma' of this Ummah, and wallahi, I tell you this, anyone who tries to say ijma' has no place is a person who wants to get the Quran and the Sunnah and understand it according to his own hawa. You know what the ijma' does? The ijma', it gets rid of anybody who wants to bring his own understanding and introduces it. It says, sorry, you don't have no place. The Ummah unanimously agreed upon this understanding, sorry. He wants to say, now that doesn't have no weight, let me contribute my thoughts into it. And it's one of the ways to what? To break the back of the sharia. When a person wants to say ijma' has no place, it's a way to strip Islam and destroy this religion. That's what it is. And who is the first person who wrote this idea that ijma' are the zanadiqa? There were zanadiqa, kuffar, malahida, who brought these thoughts forward. Who wanted what? They wanted to understand the Quran according to their own hawa, their own whims and desires. For example, today, can anybody say that the salah, is there a dispute that the five daily prayers, dhuhr, asr, maghrib, isha, and fajr, is there any dispute that it's wajib? What's your evidence that if a person comes up to you and says to you, if dhuhr is wajib, it's khilaf. Or he comes up to you and says to you, prove to me dhuhr is wajib. And when you bring him the ahadith, which clearly state to pray five daily prayers, he say to you, this command is amr istihbab. It's a command which shows recommendation. So recommendation, no, it's not obligatory. And all the nas you bring him, he throws it. The only answer you can give him is what? Ijma'ul ummah. Mun'aqid. The ummah, they unanimously came together that the five daily prayers are wajib. And if you go against the aqid, kafirun billahi al-aliyul azim. You're a kafir, you're a disbeliever. By going against this unanimous agreement of the ummah, that they unanimously agreed upon these five daily prayers. Anything after that, there's a mahallu khilaf. Is tahiyyatul masjid wajib or not? There's no ijma' that can stop you. There is views that are out there that say that it's not. And there are views that say it is. Do you see do you understand? So this is how people try to play with the matter of ijma'. And you see the ulama in every book, fiqh, aqidah, usul, even in aqa'id matters. Huh? When they write their books of aqa'id, Shaykh al-Islam Taymi, when he finishes aqidatul wasatiyah, he mentions at the ending that this book he wrote, everything he said is ijma'ul ummah. The aqidatul wasatiyah, everything in it, is the ijma' of the unanimous firqatun najiyah, Ahlul Sunnah unanimously agreed upon this. You can't go against this book, Aqidatul Wasatiyah. Does that make sense? Naam. So ijma' is a masdar min masadir al-talaqi. It's a source from the source in which we take our religion from. Al-kitabu wa-sunnah. Qiyas is disputed. Qiyas, analogy, can it be taken on board or not? It's disputed, wal-qawlu rajih is taken on board. As long as it's what? Qiyas, which is sahih, all of his conditions are met. The illah, the asal, the hukum, the fara' are all in place. The four conditions of it are in place. As for the ijma', it's taken on board. It is taken on board. And if you follow up this argument that ijma' has no place, you will find out that these people, they go back to who do they put their cell, whose chain of narration do you come back to regarding them? Zanadiqa. Zanadiqa are who? Zanadiqa are people who showed Islam, had kufr in their hearts. Zindiq means, whenever you hear that word zindiq, is a person who is what? A heretic. It's a person who shows Islam. Yudhirul Islam wa yubtinul kufr. But he has in his heart kufr. Naam. So the ijma' of the ummah is unanimously in agreement. Anyone who rejects al-ba'th, resurrection, he is a kafir. That's the ijma'. I can't today come and say, I disagree, my evidences are this, my evidences are that. No. وَقُوتِيلَ And he's killed. Ijma'. Mahallu ijma'. Anyone who rejects it. Hayya?
وَلَوْ قَالَ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ
Even if he says, لَا إِلَّا اللَّهِ If somebody says, لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ And he says, I don't believe resurrection. He is killed as a kafir. Not as killed as a Muslim who's fallen into a major sin. He's not killed a capital punishment only. He is killed. The killing here right now is what? That he's a murtad. He left Islam. Naam.
فَكَيْفَ بِمَنْ يَجْعَلُوا لِلَّهِ نِدًّا
So the Sheikh now is saying then, how is the situation like? A person who's made besides Allah ilah. He worships besides Allah ilah. What are the one who says, لا إله إلا الله. He doesn't worship besides Allah any ilah. He just says, أخي, when we become this sad, how are we going to be resurrected, أخي? Come. Look at a human being. He's finished. The earth ate him. How is he going to come back to life? I can't believe that. I don't really think so. كافر بالله العلي العظيم. He's a kafir. Then what do you think of a person who goes to an idol, goes to a graveyard, and he worships the one that's in the grave, and he's calling on to him, he's begging him. فَكَيْفَ بِمَنْ جَعَلَ لِلَّهِ أَنْدَادًا How is the situation of a one who calls on to and worships besides Allah? The answer here right now is what? لَا يَسْتَوُونَ They're not equal. The one who disbelieved in the ba'ath is less. Are you with me? It's less in terms of what he said. Like what do we believe? الْكُفْرُ مِلَّةٌ وَاحِدَةٌ Kufr is one religion. Naam.
فَإِنْ قُلْتَ قَدْ أَنْكَرَ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ عَلَى أُسَامَةَ قَتَلَهُ لِمَنْ قَالَ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهُ
He said, the Shaykh Rahimahullah said, فَإِنْ قُلْتَ if you say in response to what I've just said to you, and you try to retaliate with me by saying this, that the Prophet rejected, showed disapproval, of what Usama ibn Zaydin did after he killed the man who said La ilaha illallah. Now pay attention to this. If a person says to you, La ilaha illallah, asama minhu dima'ahu, his blood is sacred from you. and his wealth is secreted from you. And he, whether he's lying or not is between him and Allah. But if that individual comes with a naqid, something that nullifies that la ilaha illallah, that la ilaha illallah is a mujarrad da'wah. It's mere claim. It's a what? It's a mere claim. So the Shaykh rahimahullah ta'ala is saying that if you push the argument onto me and say that Usama ibn Zaydin was taught, was the Prophet spoke harshly against him, the act he did, until Usama ibn Zayd said, tamannaytu, I wish that day, anni ma aslamtu qabla, that I never took Islam before that day. I wish I became Muslim that day. That was my first day I came into Islam. This never happened. ولذلك Usama ibn Zayd, when Ali and Muawiyah were fighting, he never participated. He didn't participate. He kept his hands back. He knew what he did. He didn't want to do it again. أَقَتَلْتَهُ بَعْدَ أَنْ قَالَ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهُ. Usama, did you kill him after he said La ilaha illallah? Usama kept his hand back. ولذلك البخاري narrated in his Sahih that Usama ibn Zayd, a gift was Hassan and Hussein, they sent a gift to Usama ibn Zayd because Ali refused to give anything to him. He said, Usama, you and I were very close. We grew up together. Huh? And what you do? What did you do? You didn't come and participate and be with me. Usama said something very powerful. He said, Ya Abul Hassan, Ali ibn Abi Talib, if you entered the mouth of a lion and you slept in the cheek of a lion, I would go in there with you. Ali, if you go into the cheek of a lion and you go in the mouth of a lion, I would go in there with you. But I can't spill the blood of a believer. That one I cannot aid you with. I cannot support you in this. So the matter of blood that people take very lightly today, for somebody to be dead, killed, and that blood spills. The Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said to the Kaaba, ma a'azamak, ma ashrafak. Oh Kaaba, what is greater than you? What is more better than you? Illa damru al-Muslim, except the blood of the believer. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in a hadith, la zawalu dunya inda Allahi ahwanu min qatlu mru'in Muslim. The whole universe, the whole world to perish, to go, is less in the eyes of Allah than the blood of a believer to spill on the floor. All this blood that's pouring on the streets in Gaza, Palestine, in Syria, in there and there. To Allah, it means a lot. This is a blood that Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, for the whole entire world to go. Now imagine this. If some enemies today came and they attacked the Kaaba, if some people went out today and they attacked the Kaaba, and they went towards the Kaaba to destroy the Kaaba, what would you think that the Muslims would do? What would the Muslims do as a whole if they knew that the Kaaba was being attacked? Somebody wants to go and destroy the Kaaba? The Muslims as a whole would try to fight and retaliate and not accept that. Well, this Kaaba destroying in the eyes of Allah is less than one blood of a Muslim to spill. So La ilaha illallah means Allah. So the Shaykh is saying, if somebody comes up to me and says to me, Usama ibn Zaydin radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he killed the man after he said La ilaha illallah. So if you bring that type of argument forward to me and you say that, which is known in the books of Hadith and Seerah,
كما هو معروف في كتب الحديث والسيرة قلت لا شك أن من قال لا إله إلا الله من الكفار حقن دمه وماله حتى يتبين منه ما يخالف ما قاله ولذا أنزل الله في قصة محلم بن جثامة يا أيها الذين آمنوا إذا ضربتم في سبيل الله فتبينوا.
The Shaykh rahimahullah said, I will reply to the argument of yours by saying to you, no doubt, لا شك أن من قال لا إله إلا الله, anyone who says لا إله إلا الله, من الكفار, from the disbelievers, حقن دمه وماله, his blood, his wealth, all of them are safe and protected, no one can touch it. Until what? حتى يتبين منه ما يخالف ما قاله. Until it becomes clear that he opposes what he had just said. And that's very powerful. That لا إله إلا الله, the way you can come into Islam by saying it, there's a way to exit it and leave it as well. So the mere saying of it is not enough. Pay attention. Now there is غلو. There's إفراط and تفريط. There's extreme. By some people who go extreme this way, and there's some people who go extreme the other way. a people who don't, if you say La ilaha illallah, he still doesn't see you as a Muslim. If you say La ilaha illallah, don't worry, I don't believe you're a Muslim. I think you're lying. Those are ghulu. There's another extreme, which is what? A person comes with naqid min nawaqid al-Islam, a nullifier that nullifies your Islam, and he tells you, akhi, you're still a Muslim because you said La ilaha illallah. Don't worry, La ilaha illallah will protect you. La ilaha illallah will stand up for you the day of judgment. Hada ghulu. So, both of them are what? وَكِلَ الطَّرَفَيْنِ مَذْمُومُ. Both parties are blameworthy. It's incorrect. La ilaha illallah, saying it, if you come with what nullifies it, you come with shirk al-akbar, your La ilaha illallah is gone. It doesn't exist. It's gone. And he said also the evidence for that is that the clarification has to be done, and that we, if you come with what opposes it after we verified, he said the evidence for that is the سبب نزول الآية. This ayah, يا أيها الذين آمنوا إذا ضربتم في سبيل الله فتبينوا. This ayah in Surah An-Nisa, ayah 94, the Sheikh said it came down on the story of a man by the name of Muhallim ibn Jathama. Now that name Muhallim ibn Jathama, Bukhari Muslim narrated the story first of all. The sabab nuzul is mentioned by Bukhari and Muslim, but they did not mention the name of this Sahabi, Muhallim ibn Jathama. So they didn't mention, sorry, the name of this individual, Muhallim ibn Jathama. They mentioned it in another riwayah. Imam Ahmad mentioned it. Imam Ahmad's riwayah mentioned it. And in the chain of Imam Ahmad, one is Muddarib. There's a contradiction. There's a contradiction. Naam.
فَأَمَرَهُمُ اللَّهُ تَعَالَى بِالتَّثْبَتِ في شأن من قال كلمة التوحيد.
Allah ordered them, سبحانه وتعالى, بالتثبت, to verify. في شأن, in the affairs of anyone who says لا إله إلا الله. Verify.
فإن تبين التزامه لمعناها كان له ما للمسلمين.
If it becomes clear that he's sticking to what the meaning of لا إله إلا الله is, he sticks to it and he doesn't go out of it, he has what the Muslims have. Meaning, whatever the Muslims are going to get, he gets it with them. Whatever the Muslims don't get, he doesn't get with them. He's part of the Muslimin.
وعليهما عليهم.
And it's upon him what's upon the Muslims. The zakat they have to pay, he has to pay it with them. Whatever ghanaim and booties which they get, he gets it with them. He's from the Muslims.
وإن تبين خلافه.
If it becomes clear that he is upon opposite to what he just said.
لم يحقن دمه وماله بمجرد تلفظ.
If it becomes clear his opposition of what he said, then he said لم يحقن دمه, his blood is not secreted. وماله, and his wealth. بمجرد التلفظ, by just the mere fact of saying it. That won't help you. Mere what? Fact of saying it, it won't help you. نعم.
وهكذا كل من أظهر التوحيد.
And that is the same as everybody who shows Tawheed. We have to withhold from him. Anyone who shows Tawheed, La ilaha illallah, Muhammadan Rasulullah, stay away from him. He's a Muslim. You need to respect him as a Muslim. Give him the rights as a Muslim.
إلى أن يتبين منه ما يخالف ذلك.
Unless it becomes clear to you that he is upon opposite to the utterance of the word.
فإذا تبين.
If it becomes clear.
لم تنفعه هذه الكلمة بمجردها.
This word, by its mere essence, it won't benefit him.
ولذلك لم تنفع اليهود.
And it didn't benefit the Jews.
ولا نفعت الخوارج مع من ضم إليها من العبادة التي يحتقر الصحابة عبادة. عبادتهم إلى جنبها.
And the Khawarij, it didn't benefit them, the excessive ibadah which they came with. It didn't benefit them, in which the Prophet said that the Sahabas would belittle their own ibadah in comparison to their ibadah.
بل أمر صلى الله عليه وسلم بقتلهم.
Rather, the Prophet ordered them to be killed, the Khawarij.
وقال.
The Prophet said.
لَإِنْ أَدْرَكْتُهُمْ.
If I meet the Khawarij and I see them.
لأقتلنهم.
لأقتلنهم
قتل عاد.
I will kill them like the people of Ad. I mean, when the Prophet said, "I'm going to kill them like the people of Ad," is like I will take them off the face of this earth. I think they call it genocide, right? I will cleanse them off the face of this earth. They won't ever exist anymore. If I ever see the Khawarij, I won't let any one of them walk around. Each and every one of them. Now the Kuffar, even you can't do that to them. You can't kill all the Kuffar. You fight with some you give them jizya and you force jizya on them. Some of them you can do uhud and uqud, oaths and vows and contracts, and they're different phases. Amma khawarij la yuqtal. They are killed by an Islamic state. They are fought with and they're killed. وَذَلِكَ لَمَّا خَالَفُوا بَعْضَ الشَّرِيعَةِ. That is after they opposed some of the legislation. They didn't even oppose everything. They only opposed some of the legislation.
وَكَانُوا شَرَّ الْقَتْلَ تَحْتَ أَدِيمِ السَّمَاءِ.
And they are the evilest people to be ever killed under the sky. The worst people. وَكَانُوا, they are شَرَّ قَتْلَ, the most evilest people to be killed تَحْتَ أَدِيمِ السَّمَاءِ, under the sky. They're the worst people.
كَمَا ثَبَتَتْ بِهِ الْأَحَادِيثِ.
As the evidences have shown. لذلك, there are a lot of evidences. From those evidences is what? The narration of Abu Umamah al-Bahili, when he saw them all on the ground. And then he said to them, Kilabu, Kilabu al-Nar. You guys are the dogs of the hellfire. To all of them on the ground, as they were dead. And then the narrator, he said to Abu Umamah al-Bahili, أَسَمِعْتَهَا مِنْ رَسُولِ اللَّهِ. Are you saying this from your own self, or did you hear the Prophet say this? And he looked, and he said, destruction is on me. If I am one who says things from his own self, I heard it from the messenger, not once, not twice, not three times, but so many times, that they are the dogs of the hellfire. So evidences, and Abu Umamah al-Bahili ordered for all of them to be thrown into the well, not to be buried like the Muslims. They were taken and they were all thrown into the well. So there was never, within Islamic time, there wasn't. ولذلك علي بن أبي طالب, when he killed them, he prostrated to Allah. سجود الشكر. He thanked Allah that he destroyed these people. Ha. لأن these people, محمد نصر المروزي in his كتاب تعظيم قدر الصلاة. Imagine this. A man comes into the masjid. محمد نصر المروزي. He mentions this in his book تعظيم قدر الصلاة. A man comes into the masjid. Before he comes into the masjid, this man, the Sahabas used to always tell the Prophet about this man to the Prophet. Ya Rasulullah, there's this man, ibadah, ta'a, righteousness. He's an amazing individual. Amazing individual. They described him to the Prophet. The Prophet somehow could not realize who he was. He said, I don't know. I don't know who he is. As they were talking, he came in. They said, Ya Rasulullah, there he is. There he is. The Prophet looked at him and he said, he's a man from the hellfire. He's on his face. Shaitan lies on his face. He's a man from the hellfire. Then when the man passed by, the Prophet said, who's going to take the responsibility of going and killing that man? Who's going to go and go kill him? Abu Bakr stood up and he went. He went over him and he saw the man standing and praying in the salah. He came back, he said, Ya Rasulullah, the man is in the salah. How am I going to kill him? The Prophet said, who's going to go and kill him? Umar went. He saw him and he was in sujood. Umar came back, he said, Ya Rasulullah, the man is in sujood. أَقْرَبُ مَا يَكُونُ عَبْدِ رَبِّهِ وَوَسَاجِ. The time when the servant is the most closest to Allah. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Ali voluntarily said, Ya Rasulullah, I'm going to go and kill him. I'm going to kill this guy. The Prophet said, I don't think you're going to go and reach him when you go there. You're not going to find him there. So Ali went and he didn't find the man. When Ali came back, the Prophet, Ali said, Ya Rasulullah, I couldn't find him. The Prophet said, if you killed him, that would have been an end of a fitna. To kill that man, and you got rid of him, Khawarij and their khubth and their evil would not have stopped, carried on. In another riwayah, Abu Nasr al-Marwazi brings different narrations. In another riwayah, he brings that the Prophet ﷺ, he voluntarily showed the Sahabas why this man is a man who deserves to be killed. So he asked the man, he said to him, when you came to us and you saw us sitting down, did you think to yourself that you were better than everyone in this gathering? He said, yes. Who's part of the gathering? Nabiullah Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He believes he's more closer to Allah than the Prophet. He believes he's standing up for the Sharia. He's making the religion up. He's standing, he loves the religion than everyone else. And he's looking at. So kafara billah, kafir. The Prophet was kinni mazam, kafir. So what does that show you, brothers? What does that show? That these people, these signs and these alamat that the people get. ولذلك, the issue of the Khawarij reached haddu tawatur. The narrations are more than hundreds. There are more than what? 100 narrations regarding their affairs. And there is no group in which the Prophet was explicit in the way he spoke about than the Khawarij. So there are people who can deceive the people of the Sunnah. They can deceive. They can deceive what? The people of the lame people of the Sunnah. People of Misakeen, who, mashallah, upon the fitrah, who aqeedah are not corrupt, they can easily get fooled by them. But not by the ulama or rasikhun, not the grounded scholars, who know their characteristics and their way they look. So be very careful where you take your knowledge from. And look at what you're learning in mas'ala. Who from the salaf al-salih, from the pious predecessors said this? And who from the sahabas understood the verse like this? But just to take an ayah from the Quran and just read the ayah's English translation and to think that you understood it better than everyone before you. Man fahimaha, who understood it in this way? This is the problem with these people. They never brought the matter back to the ulama. Ayah, you read it, bring it to those who know, who studied, who know the qawa'id, who know the usul, who know the matters very well, who are from the people of knowledge, and they'll put it in context for you. Now,
فثبت أن مجرد قول كلمة التوحيد غير مانع من ثبوت الشرك من قالها لارتكابه
ألف الوصل لارتكابه you don't pronounce it
لارتكابه ما يخالفها من عبادة غير الله
فثبت it became clear now and it's affirmed أن مجرد كلمة التوحيد the mere pronunciation of the كلمة التوحيد غير مانع من ثبوت الشرك is not a prevention from the shirk being present in you. The pronunciation by itself doesn't prevent you from that. من قالها لارتكاب ما يخالفها من عبادة غير الله. When he goes and he commits what? He commits to something that opposes it, which is what? Worshipping besides Allah. That's what he does. Irtikab means is to commit, is to do. So just the mere pronunciation of La ilaha illallah is not enough. Na'am.
فَإِنْ قُلْتَ
If you say to me, again, just try to use an argument with me. So now he's making a dialogue. And these are one of the ways a student of knowledge can learn. The Shaykh is teaching you in a way where they say and you say. They say and you should say in reply. And this, without a doubt, and Imam al-Shafi'i did that in his book, Al-Risala. His book, Jima'ul Ilm, and Jumma'ul Ilm. Both ways it's said. He does that. He makes it as a what? Person who's this and this. There's a book written by Sheikh Abdurrahman Nasir al-Sa'di, rahimahullah. It's called, Al-Munadharatu fil Fiqh, something like that. Where he writes two men discussing this issue. He makes it like two people who are discussing an issue. And mashallah, you're learning whilst discussion between two people. So you lead to, he said, okay, what's he going to reply back? Okay, what's he going to reply back with? Very well. And this is how it's going now. Na'am.